This is a short little trip we had to Color Rock Quarry. We started the day off on the other side of the mountains over by Lake Mead area, and there's a place called Anniversary Mine Trail or Road, and that's where we started. And then from there we cut across the desert all the way through like the Nelson Air Force Dune area and the outside of that, and then from the outside of the dune area we made our way north towards Valley of Fire Lake and then hooked up with Color Rock Quarry Road or Trail. And this is our trip to Color Rock Quarry. So technically we've been driving down the trail for a little while, and this is where we stopped and I saw an overlook that we could look out on, and I took some pictures or whatever, but this is where I decided to throw the GoPro up. We were out all day, so I didn't want to have the GoPro necessarily recording everything. Most of it is pretty flat and, you know, washboards and more like power line. There's like a power line that we ran, and that's, you know, basically like graded gravel with some hills and whatnot. So anyway, so we're coming back down and then we'll get back on to the actual trail, and then from there we'll head up and we'll see like the Color Rock Quarry area and like a little side shot. There's like a little side trail that goes up and around and sees a bunch of cool looking rocks, rock formations, sandstone formations back there. So we go do that first, and then you head up towards like where the mine area is, and there's still like a little mine, stone mine building there where people have littered, probably including the miners and whatnot. But it's kind of a neat old stone building, and we don't spend any time going through there. We've done this trail before, but it was just mostly just to just get out and spend the day driving and see things and look at pretty and stay away from people and whatnot. So just interject when I think it's necessary, but for the most part, just enjoy the ride. this little back side of these rocks here is pretty cool. There's like, you know, little caves and little rock formations you can climb on and around. There's a trail area that starts back here. You see where I can go up and turn around and then come back, but so if you're into hiking and stuff, like there's stuff you can do there. And then when we come out of this, not this section, but after the next section, we pop out where we just joined the rocks. And you can see on the right-hand side, there'll be like a whole other area where they have like little posts in the ground so people don't drive over there. But it says there's a trail there so you can go hiking up there too. And I have not done it. Here, I realize I missed the turn. So you can get to the little cabin or miner's hut or whatever that is up there by going straight and then taking a right, or you can take this road up through here, and it's gotten washed out a little bit over the years. So there's a couple rocks, nothing too big, but. First time I came here, I I drove down. This time I was just like, I wanted to remember to drive up because up is better. GoPro sees it better. Now again, I don't know if this is like a building for like the mine operations or if it was someone's house or any of that. I don't know, but I mean, it looks pretty nice and it looks kind of like maybe they preserved it, and it definitely looks 10 times better in the, it's very cloudy and it's sprinkled on and off during the day. Just light sprinkles. It was supposed to rain maybe, but I don't think it rained here. But I tell you, if you come in here during the summertime, it looks a lot different, especially the light. Like the sun is so bright and it's like it just washes everything out, even with your eyes. And I'm sure it was dry, so it's probably dusty, and I just remember it looking a lot lighter than it does here. But it looks super cool. And again, there's kids showed up and graffitied the inside because that's what kids do. Just like people with guns just can't help but shoot signs that say no shooting and every other thing out in the desert. Now here, when I was driving up before I, you know, drove up to the cabin part, I saw that there was a trail that goes along those rocks right back there. So instead of taking a left and heading back, I saw that looks like this is where the exit was for that little section. So that's what I did. Popped out, took a right, and followed this up. I thought it was going to go up alongside those rocks, but didn't actually. It just got closer to them than where the wash was. Here's another trail of just the wash area, but it's like, oh yeah, there it is. Now this kind of goes up towards those rocks in the background, and I don't know what they look like, you know, on my phone, but in person they're really cool looking. I just love it out here. I love all the different rock formations and all the different landscape formations and all the different plants and fauna and whatnot. It's like you've got different colored rocks everywhere, different colored plants, and you know, some areas have no cactuses, some areas have tons of cactuses, different kinds, multiple kinds, you know, just one kind. It just, I mean, seems like every time we take a corner or a different mile or a different side of a mountain, it's like it's completely different. Trees, no trees, types of trees. The West is just so much more interesting than I thought possible. It's really awesome being out here. As always, if you made it this far, thanks for watching.